Blessed morning. For this is the day that the Lord He has made. I shall rejoice and I shall be glad in it. We are giving honor to God this morning, for God is truly, truly awesome and amazing. What a mighty God that we serve. We ask that as you come in this morning, that you come in sharing the live. I keep forgetting to put out where's this music. We pray that what is said this morning, that it will bless you. As I am looking to see what God is going to do, we are super excited to be in the presence of God. As you come in, please tag and share. Please tag and share.
I don't dot every I. Got more flaws than a little, and I'm messed up a thousand times. I don't always commit.
Sometimes I give up way too quick.
I try and run away from who I am to who I wanna be. Some things are better than others.
Yes.
I can be up and
I'm down.
Found in your graces, this one thing will never change. You still love me, in spite of me.
Yes.
You still chose me, how can it be?
Yes. In spite of me. I'm stubborn at heart. Quick to put up a gun. I do it all by myself. And don't ask for help. Yes, God. Some days are better than others.
You still love me, in spite of me. You still chose me, how can it be?
You see it all. Blessed morning.
How can it be? Every star, you see it all. You still love me, And if you say yeah, how can I get a witness? You didn't give me what I deserve. That's so ridiculous. I'm singing hallelujah.
Can I get a witness? You still love me, in spite of me. You still chose me. How can it be?
You see it all. You still love me. Love me.
He loves you in spite of you. He loves you.
It's hard to believe you have a choice.
You have a choice.
And daily.
You choose me. I cannot share this to my page.
You have a choice.
Share it on my page.
You have a choice.
And daily.
You still choose.
It's choice. And daily you choose me. You never gave up on me. You never gave up on me. God never gives up on us. He never gives up on us. Yes. I'm trying to get this shared to my page. I know people monitor my page a little bit more. It's always in opposition, but we push through in despite of it. Because God, He loves us. He loves us. All right. Thank you. Praise God. Praise God. I want to play this song. I heard this song the other day, and I want to play it, and I want you all to listen to what he's saying. Mayday, mayday, the earth is shaking. Who gonna save the babies? Come another bloody Sunday. I'm singing mayday, mayday. They love me or they hate me. But you say that I am your brother. The government keeps lying to me. They say they come to set the people free. But the power comes when you catch us on our knees. We're in a state of emergency and we need a strong God. We need the real God. With the resurrection power from the grave. To take away the hate and heal the human race. I ask that as you come in, please share this live. Yes, Lord.
They said the climate changing.
You tag on the show.
Poor people in the cold. But you keep reaching to their soul. But we don't need till everybody's free. And we won't sleep till everybody eats.
Yes, yes. Blessed morning, until lives matter.
More than tithes matter.
The government keeps lying to me that they come to set the people free. But the power falls when you catch us on our knees. We're in a state of emergency and we need a strong God. A real God. To take away the hate and heal the human race. Blessed morning, share the live, yes, blessed morning, we want justice, we want change, no more pain, we want peace, we want people to be free, we need a strong God, we need a strong God.
My country, tears of thee.
Yes, Lord.
Land of liberty.
Help us, God.
When will we finally see?
When will we finally see? We need a strong God.
The government keep lying to me.
Yes, Lord.
Telling me that they're going to set the people free. But the power falls when you catch us on,
when you catch us on our knees.
We're in a state of emergency.
We're in a state of emergency. And we need a strong God. We need a real God. The God with the resurrection power from the grave to take away the hate and heal our human race. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes. help us, Lord. We're in a state of emergency. We're in a state of emergency. My God, we need a strong God. Blessed morning, blessed morning, blessed morning to everyone that has joined today. I know that it has been such a long time that I have not come on and done the morning encouragement, but glory be unto the Lord, our God. We have been truly and still going through some things. We ask that you keep us and our families uplifted in prayer as we are grieving and still grieving and still losing loved ones. And we just plead the blood of Jesus today. This morning, I want to read from the book of Galatians this morning. If you have your Bible, I ask that you go to Galatians chapter 5. If you do not have your Bible, I will read the scripture text. But the Lord is really dealing with me and helping me to speak and teach about love. And I think it's very important for us to understand that love is very essential. The Bible tells us that love cures a multitude of sin. And it as much as love is free, it seems like it costs so much. You know, we seek love, we desire love, but yet because of the things that we have encountered, the things that we have gone through, blessed morning to you, Overseer. God bless you. Thank you for joining. The things that we have gone through, we sometimes find ourselves in a very dark place or a place where it comes very hard or very challenging for us to love or to sometimes to be a recipient of love. And the Bible gives us instructions on how to love. And in the book of Galatians, I'm going to read this because it talks about the fruits of the Spirit. And I'm going to start at the 16th verse. Actually, I'm going to go up and start from the 13th verse, and I am reading from the Amplified Version. And I played that song this morning, the two songs that I played this morning. The first one is by Tasha Cobbs, and it says, "In spite of me." So it explains how God loves us in spite of us, in spite of the things that we do, in spite of the complications that we cause, in spite of how we may not do what God tells us to do. He still loves us, even when we're stubborn and when we struggle. Some days are better than others. Life can give us ups and downs, but he still sees us beyond our mistakes, and he still loves us. And then the other song says that we need a strong God, the one who has the power, the resurrection power to bring us from the dead. And right now we are living in times where there are a lot of dead among us, and people are not loving the way they should, and people are hurting and broken, and they're losing people in their lives, and people are trying to find a way out, and it seems like they don't know which way to go. So it's very important for us as believers to stand on the principle of God, and that is to love in despite of. So Galatians chapter 5 verse 13, and I'll start, and I'm going to read until I probably get to the 23rd or 24th verse. And it says, "For you, my brothers, were called to freedom." And it says, "Only do not let your freedom become an opportunity for the sinful nature, worldliness, and selfishness, but through love, serve and seek the best for one another." So that means that if I love you, I want you to have the best. I'm not competing with you. I'm not trying to hinder you. I want you to grow as I grow, or grow beyond me. "For the whole law concerning human relationships is fulfilled in one precept: you shall love your neighbor as you love yourself. That is, you shall have an unselfish concern for others and do things for their benefit. But if you bite and devour one another," listen to the word of God, people of God, this morning, "in bickering and strife, what out that you, along with your entire fellowship, are not consumed by one another? But I say, walk habitually in the Holy Spirit. Seek him and be responsive to his guidance, and then you will certainly not carry out the desire of the sinful nature, which responds impulsively without regard for God and his precepts. For the sinful nature has its desire, which is opposed to the spirit, and the desire of the spirit opposes the sinful nature. For these two, the sinful nature and the spirit, are in direct opposite to each other, continually in conflict, so that you, as believers, do not always do whatever good things you want to do. But if you are guided and led by the Spirit, you are not subject to the law. Now, the practices of the sinful nature are clearly sorcery, hostility, strife, jealousy, fits of anger, disputes, dissensions, factions that promote heresies, envy, drunkenness, ritualist behavior, and other things like these. I warn you beforehand, just as I did previously, that those who practice such things will not inherit the kingdom of God. But the fruit of the Spirit, the result of His presence within us, come on, church, is love, unselfish concern for others, joy, inner peace, patience, not the ability to wait, but how we act while waiting. Kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Against such things there is no law. And those who belong to Christ Jesus has crucified the sinful nature together with his passions and appetites. This morning, I simply come to encourage you today to love. Love with patience. Now, I read this the other night, and when I reread it, I was having a conversation with someone, and when I read that, that hit me, because it says when we love, we're patient, but it says not the ability to wait, but how we act while we're waiting. So have you ever prayed to God for something and you feel like God is not delivering it fast enough? So then you stop trusting God because you didn't get what you want when you felt like you needed it or when you felt like you should have it. But we have to understand that God's timing is not our timing, and we have to patiently wait on God because God loves us enough to say, I'm going to give it to you when you need it. I know to hear the song in my head says that he's an on time God. Yes, he is. He may not come when you want him, but he'll be there, and he'll be there right on time. And we have to understand that the times that we're in is a clear evidence that the love that we need for one another has declined. So I come to encourage you this morning that we love you and we are praying for you. That in despite of the enemy trying to tell you that there's nobody that cares, you have people that love you. And in despite of even us as the people, you have a God that sits high on the throne, that sits and watches you, and he protects you and he guards you. It is time for us to step outside of the sinful nature, to no longer do the things that the flesh desires, but to do the things that the Spirit requires of us to do. Because when the Spirit of God lives in us, we obey the Spirit of God. You get an unction to call somebody, but they made you mad. So you don't want to call them because you're mad at them. No, call them anyways. Understand that God is always working in the midst. All things, they work together. They work together for the good of those who love the Lord. The scripture didn't just say that they work. It says that they work together because God causes all things to work together, the scripture says. So we have to understand that when we walk as Christians, when we walk as believers, that we are to love our neighbor as we love ourselves. But here's where the problem comes about. How can I love you if I don't know how to love me? So if I don't love me, that means that blessed morning, Pastor Fuller. God bless you. If I don't love me, I can't love you because I don't know how to love myself. So the order of love should be that you build an intimacy and a relationship with God. Relationship with God is very essential in our walk and in our journey. So when you connect with God and you build a relationship with God, you love on God, you give God your time, you sacrifice and say, God, I'm going to put this aside and I'm going to begin to fast and to pray. I'm going to wake up, God, with you on my mind. Because let me touch some of y'all right quick. When you get into a relationship with a person, you know how y'all be. Y'all up late at night on the phone. You sleepy? No, I ain't sleepy. I can stay up all night. But when it come time for the shut-in all night prayer, you're snoring or you can't make it. Or when it's time to get up for the 5:30 a.m. prayer, you tired. Oh, your pillow is just getting real close to your heart at that time of the morning. But in order to be able to love, you have to be able to rebuild a relationship and love the Father. Because when you love God, He'll teach you how to love you. And when you learn how to love you, you'll learn how to love others. Love God. Love you. Love others. Love your neighbor as you love yourself. You know, there's a saying that says, hurt people hurt people. It's time for us to be healed, people of God. And we cannot be healed if we're not spending any time with God. There are people out there in this world and they're hurting. They're looking for love. We have people that have been abused and going through strife, and they've been hurt and lied to and lied on and manipulated and dealing with all these things. And they're just looking for someone to just be gentle, to just be gentle, just to give a listening ear, not always have something to say. Love is not impulsive. You establish self-control. So even when you want to say something against someone or someone has made you mad, you exemplify self-control. Because if you were at work and your boss said something to you out the way, I guarantee you, you're not going to say nothing because you don't want to lose your job. But yet in the street, where God should be exemplified in your life, in closed doors and outside of those doors. You shouldn't be a different person in your house and outside your house. We walk in truth. So when God is in us and the Holy Spirit is guiding us, the Holy Spirit is a discerner. But the problem is we can't hear the discerner because we're not listening. We're operating in our flesh and we don't understand how important it is to die to the flesh. We must decrease so that he may increase. So what happened to the sacrifice? Oh, well, Pastor, in the Bible, Samuel told Saul that obedience is better than sacrifice. It is. But when you are obedient, you're also sacrificing. We don't want to wake up for God, but you'll wake up for man. You'll wake up faithfully to go clock in, but you won't wake up faithfully to serve a God who is the one that breathes life into you. If you can't love on God, you will not be able to have the capacity to love people. So it's time to get our heart posture correct. It's time to uplift one another, to be doers and helpers of each other. Because the times that we're living in and what we're getting ready to face, we're going to need to be able to connect and stand with one another, not against each other. We're living in times where people are putting stipulations on how people can enter into the church. The church is a place where we come to get deliverance and healing. The church is a place where we come to worship and to fellowship. A place where the drug addict should come and say, I can come in and get delivered. A place where the prostitute can say, I can walk in and I can be set free. A place where someone that is sick with leprosy in their body can come in and say, in that place, in that temple, in that church is where I can be healed. No restrictions. But now, I have restrictions on how you can enter into here. What God are we serving? God is love. And he embraces us in despite of us. That's what the song says. In despite of me, he loves me. He chose me. How can this be? Some days are better than others. Sometimes life goes up and it goes down. But beyond my mistakes, he still gives me grace. But we don't have grace for the people of God. We want God's grace, but we will not be gracious to others. That is not how that works. That is very hypocritical. I want God to be gracious on me, but I won't give the people grace. We got to check our heart, people of God. We have to check where we are and how we're walking and how we're living. Because this word says that the practices of the sinful nature are clearly evident. That means that we can see these things. You want love? Spend time with God. I know they hurt you. I know they walked away. I know they said that you wouldn't amount to nothing. Guess what? They told me the very same thing. The very same thing. I wouldn't even graduate. I have more than one degree, and I graduated. When God is before you, no woman or demon in hell could ever be against you. So stop listening to the naysayer and listen to the God that we serve. Because God says that you are more than a conqueror. God says that you are above and not beneath. But you have to build a relationship with him to understand his word. And you have to study the word to show yourself approved. We're in war. I keep praying in the mornings. Witches are becoming extremely bold, more bold than what they were before. The devil is more bolder now than what he has ever been. And the saints of God have to pray. And you're going to have to learn how to use the power that God gave you. And I keep hearing the Lord say, he didn't say that he gave power to an apostle or to a pastor or to a minister or an evangelist. He gave the power to the believer. He says, I give you power and authority. He didn't say I give it to the fivefold. Yes, we may have it, but he also gave it to every believer. And you have the power and the authority to bind every serpent, every snake, every enemy, every witch, every warlock that comes against you. And you're going to have to cast them down in the spirit. Now, on that part is when I get choked up. Let me tell you something. These witches are praying around the clock. They're casting spells around the clock. We are at war, people of God, and we're going to have to learn how to pray. Because the power is not what we speak, is what we pray. And when you do not know what to pray, the Holy Spirit will step in and intercede for you. It's time to push. Prostrate until the shift happens. Position yourself until the shift happens. I know someone saying, well, wait a minute, isn't pray until something happens? Do that too. But you need to prostrate yourself before God until the shift happens. We need to see something move. We got to love people of God, our children. We see politics running rampant, the government running rampant. People coming against each other, even in the body of Christ. Pray. Stay in prayer. Stay fasting, not just for yourself. The scripture, Isaiah 58 and 6 says, is this not the fast that we have chosen, to loose the bands of wickedness, to undo heavy burdens, to let the oppressed go free, and to break every yoke? Not just your own yoke. We need to break every yoke. Not just that, in Ecclesiastes 8 and 8 in the NIV version, the last part of that scripture, I'm paraphrasing, says that those who practice wickedness, wickedness will not release them. We have to pray, people of God, and stay in position. Build your relationship with God. Love on God, because he's already loving you. We need a strong God. We need a strong God. So we thank you this morning for joining the morning encouragement. We thank you. I pray that there's something that I've said today to encourage you to walk in love, to trust God, knowing that God will provide for you, that God will give you what you need. The Lord will give you the desires of your heart. You just have to trust him. Trust him and believe that the Lord will see you through. And despite of what you have going on, God is always there. And he loves us. He needs you to love him too. Some of you may say, oh, but I love God. If you love God, that means you are obedient to his word. It doesn't mean you're not going to make mistakes or you're not going to fall short, but you are obedient to his word. To love God is to obey him. So we thank the Lord this morning. Trust in the Lord and do good, and know that ye shall always be fed, and that ye shall dwell in the land for that forever. Know that all things that they work together for the good of those who love the Lord and who are called according to his purpose. Seek ye first the kingdom of heaven and God's righteousness, and in all things acknowledge God in all of your ways, and he will direct your path. Be sober-minded, well-balanced, and vigilant in your spirit, because that enemy of yours, the devil, he roams around like a fierce lion, and he's seeking for someone to devour. He's seeking. He doesn't have you. He's seeking. So him. Who's him? Jesus. H-I-M-M. He is molding me. We pray. We P-R-A-Y. We prioritize righteousness around you. We are hashtagging addicted to Jesus. S2P, we want your soul to prosper. We bought that Jesus life. We stay ready. Yes, we do. We stay ready. We chucking up the deuces to Satan because he got to go. Deuces, he got to go. He got to pack all his bags, everything he done brought. Well, he getting evicted because we not scared. We ain't scared. Yes, I said we ain't scared, right? I'm bad. I am B-A-D. I am blessed and delivered. We're rocking with the best. J-E-S-U-S. They play checkers. We play chess. We're strategic in how we serve the Lord. Tighten up. We live a life of prosperity. We're hashtagging. We are restored. Pump your brakes. Use me, Lord, for your glory. Stop being extra. You cannot be healed from what you do not reveal. You are what you answer to. We don't shake. We shift. We pray together. We praise together. We're kingdom for life. Don't say it. Just pray it. Don't compromise who and what you are in Christ for anyone or anything. God will bring you out without a doubt. Trust God even when you cannot trace him. We will not bow to anyone or anything but Jesus. And we will get over. Oh, how I got over. My soul looks back in wonder how I got over. We will get over. We're not living in a pandemic. We're living in a shiftdemic. Stay in your lane. We're worshipers, baby, and we stay ready so we don't have to get ready. We will not be moved. You cannot evangelize and antagonize at the same time. And you guys know it is that time. Our most personal favorite, the one that we love so much. I'm ready. I need my drum roll, please. We kingdom, baby. Listen, we kingdom, baby. We walk under a kingdom mentality. We walk under kingdom authority. We thank the Lord. I do want to share great news, and I ask that if you're awake tomorrow, join us in service on the phone. The number is 561-214-8410. The access code is 909-648. So 561-214-8410, access code 909-648. Did you text us, Denise Johnson? And we start at 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. And we have a wonderful time on the line with God. He truly moves. And we want to announce, and we will keep announcing, that Family Media Ministries, we are now in the process of looking for a church building. We are now Restoration at the Well. Family Media Ministries will be our outreach ministry, but we are now Restoration at the Well Church, and we welcome you to our home. Right now we are in the process of finding our building, as we said. So if you would like to give and help us, if you know a building that is for lease or for sale in the South Florida area, please reach out to us and let us know, because we are looking in South Florida, which is where we are. So we pray and we're trusting God that the building will be open soon. But we thank God for what he's doing. So in the comments, I believe they have put the information there that if you would like to sow today or you would like to just simply bless and help us in the building of our church and to acquire the building, you can give to 833-892-1426. So you would just simply text that number and text the word give, and you'll receive a link back that prompts you to go in and give to help us. And you can actually select what you're giving for. So if it's for a seed, you can select that. If it's for the building fund, you can select that as well. And we just thank God for what he's doing. We're excited because God is doing great things and God is faithful. So I encourage you this morning to just love God. That has kept me. Just my love and my relationship with God, it has kept me. So I encourage you to trust your Father because he'll never let you down. So have a blessed and prosperous day. Keep your head up and smile. Know that you matter, that you're important, and that you mean something. So I encourage you today, be encouraged and stay encouraged. And remember to encourage someone today. Walk with God and know that he walks with you. And know that God loves you, and so do we. Have a blessed day, people of God. God bless you.